Donna Wolfe from Naztazia.com. Today I'm going to show you how to make
this crochet dog, also known as Amigurumi. I also have another video on my channel for the cat. To view this video in other languages, just click on the closed caption link on YouTube and turn on subtitles. From there, you can choose from over 100 different languages. To begin, you will need some worsted weight yarn and a size F hook. These are the body parts that comprise the crocheted item. Please note, this video is not for beginners. If you need help, check out my beginner crochet and amigurumi videos on YouTube. We'll start with the head. To begin, do a magic ring or magic loop, which is just a loose slip knot. Then chain one. For round one, do 6 single crochet stitches in the ring. 3, 4, 5, 6. Pull the starting end to tighten the ring. Since we're working in spirals, you will need a stitch marker. For round two, do 2 single crochet stitches in each stitch around. Mark every first stitch to designate the beginning of each round. Finish the second single crochet in that same stitch. And do 2 single crochets in the next stitch and in each stitch around. Once completed, you will have completed 12 single crochets for this round. For round 3, begin with your first of 2 single crochets. Then mark that first stitch. Complete your second single crochet in the same stitch. On this round, the pattern will be 2 single crochets, then 1 single crochet, then 2 single crochets, then 1 single crochet, all the way around for a total of 18 stitches. For round 4, we're going to begin the same way. 2 single crochet stitches in the first space, marking that first single crochet you made. Then do 1 single crochet in the next stitch, followed by 1 single crochet in the next stitch. Repeat this process all the way around for a total of 24 stitches. Round 5 starts out in a similar way to what we've done before. Do 2 single crochets in the first stitch, followed by 1 single in each of the next 3 stitches, for a total of 30 stitches on this round. Round 6 will be the last round that we increase on. First stitch will have 2 single crochets. Then you will do 1 single crochet in each of the next 4 stitches. Repeat this 2, 1, 1, 1, 1, all the way around for a total of 36 stitches. Rounds 7 through 13. You will just do 1 single crochet in each stitch around. Each round will have 36 single crochet stitches on it, and there will be a total of 7 rounds. If you have any confusion, please see my beginner amigurumi video, which shows these same steps in a bit more detail. Round 14 begins our decrease round. We will do a single crochet 2 together in the first 2 stitches, using just the front loops only. Mark this stitch. Then, just do 1 single crochet in each of the next 4 stitches. Here's that single crochet 2 together decrease again. Then just follow it with one single crochet in each of the next 4 stitches. Round 15 will begin with a similar decrease process as well. Do a single crochet 2 together, decrease over the first 2 stitches. Then do 1 single crochet in each of the next 3 stitches. Repeat this process all the way around. Finally, for round 16, begin with your normal single crochet 2 together stitch. Then follow it with 1 single crochet in each of the next 2 stitches. Your head will look something like this once you have completed all of the rounds. Fasten off. Then, I like to cut a long 18-inch tail at the end. This way, I have enough yarn for sewing the body parts together. Next, you'll need to make the body. The body is made in a similar method to the head, except where we did 7 rounds of plain single crochet stitches for the head, for the body, you will increase that number to 14 rounds of plain single crochet stitches. Now, we'll move on to the ears. The ears begin in a similar manner as we made the head. You will do a magic ring, then chain 1. Do 6 single crochet stitches in the ring. Then pull the initial starting end tightly to close the ring. For round 2, do 2 single crochet stitches in each stitch around. For round 3, do 2 single crochet stitches, followed by 1 single crochet stitch. Repeat this 2-1-2-1 process all the way around. For rounds 4 through 18, you will just do 1 single crochet around. Each round will have a total of 18 stitches on it. Once your ear is completed, flatten it out into a traditional floppy ear shape. And as before, fasten off, but leave an 18-inch tail for sewing. The next body parts are the 4 legs and paws. To begin, do a magic ring, chain 1, and do 6 single crochets in the ring. This time, do a slip stitch to the first stitch. Then, chain 1. For round 2, we're going to do 2 single crochet stitches in each stitch around, for a total of 12 stitches. And as before, slip stitch to the first stitch and chain 1. For rounds 3 to 17, do 1 single crochet stitch around. At some point before the 17th round, you might want to switch colors. To do this, grab a hold of the new color yarn. Then, insert your hook as if you were going to slip stitch to the first stitch. Loop the new white yarn around the hook. Pull it through and complete your slip stitch. Chain 1, then continue using the new white yarn in your work. After you make the 4 paws, you can make the tail. The tail is made just like the paws, and you can customize the tail to be longer or shorter if you want. Once the body parts are all made, it's time to sew everything together. I like to start with the ears first. Thread a yarn needle with the ear yarn and place it on the side of the head. Squeeze the ear together and begin taking small stitches, sewing the ear to the head. you'll want to ensure you are also sewing the top of the ear closed while connecting it to the head. Once completed, poke the needle through the head and take a few small stitches underneath to secure this connection. You can also tie a knot or two, or even put a dot of glue inside to really ensure it stays. I like to use safety eyes, but you can use whatever you want. Glue-on eyes, buttons, or even embroidered eyes. Whatever you use, be sure it is appropriate from a safety perspective for your recipient, especially if he or she is a younger child. You can take some embroidery floss and a yarn needle to add some details to the face. You can take small stitches or longer stitches and make a mouth, some eyebrows, a dimple, a few whiskers here and there, as well as eyelashes. Once the head is completed, I like to take some polyester fiberfill, which can be purchased at most craft stores, and stuff the head. This same polyester filling is also found inside many non-allergenic pillows as well. Next, you'll want to sew on the four legs and paws. I like to stuff the legs a bit with some fiberfill first. You can sew on the leg in a round manner like this. Or what I do is pinch the top of the leg closed and sew it onto the body like that. When you sew on the leg, you will want to ensure that you have sufficiently closed the top of the leg shut while sewing so that none of the polyester fiberfill gets loose or comes out. I take small stitches and go in and out and in and out with the yarn and needle. Remember to sew on the tail as well. Once all of the lower body parts are completely sewn, I like to stuff the body with more polyester fiberfill. Finally, it is time to sew on the head. Position the head onto the body, then take a needle and the yarn strand and make small stitches, connecting the head to the body. At the end, be sure you weave in ends extra carefully. You can always put a dot or two of fabric glue to ensure that the knots and ends are more secure. And here is one of my finished dogs.
I hope this video has helped you.
Please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Check out the description of this video for more information.
And please visit Naztazia.com for more tips and tricks on creative, self-sufficient living.